Church, viewers, good morning. You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. I have done my own dance. I will have show it now, but I've been dancing since while you are dancing. I was dancing, I was a viewer, but now here I am. Hallelujah. I'm looking forward to see when you allow me to put on suit. When some of your spirit will allow me to put on suit. When we will not fight, because I'm seeing little fight today. That is why I had to dress this way. So please. I'm saying, allow me to wear tie. You allow me one day to wear tie. Because I view what I'm going to meet today, and I realize that, on the outside, these people can be very funny. But on the inside, greater is he. Hallelujah. Yes. Is this issue of faith? Only faith pleases God. It's given me so much concern, so much concern. People are not going through faith to talk to God anymore. People imagine God hear them. That is imagination. To learn how to believe that God hears us when we pray is a much, much greater blessing than healing, deliverance, just name. To learn how to believe that God hears us when we pray is much, much greater blessing, greater than any. But how many of us today? And you stand up to pray, Lord Jesus, and you know he's hearing you, and you are hearing him. How many of you? How many of us today? Tell your neighbor to learn how to believe that God hears us when we pray is a much greater blessing than healing, than deliverance, than whatever you are waiting for. Ask your neighbor, can you hear when you pray? To learn how to believe that God hears you when you pray is a much greater blessing. But today, here we are. And I say, until I say pray, it is pray. You say, stand up. No. It's not by command, it's not by order, it's by belief. So there was a question I threw last three meeting here, that it is never proper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Why? Because the prayer of faith can be repeated 1,000 times. Jesus, give me bread. Jesus may say, hold on. Not that I will not give you, but hold on. This is not the right time to give you. That does not mean your prayer is not answered. Jesus, I want to run. It's not the right thing for you now to run. You know what happened? Jesus prayed that cup be taken away from him 3 times. The same prayer he offered 3 times. That does not mean his prayer was not answered. The cup should be taken away from him 3 times. Let's quickly take a look at the book of Matthew. Matthew 26. We take our reading from verse 36. It said, then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to them, sit here while I go over there and pray. That said Jesus to his disciples. He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him. But he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, my soul is overwhelming with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watching with me. Stay here and keep watching with me. Going a little further, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed. My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken away from me. Yet, not as I will, but as you will. Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. Could not you men keep watching with me for 1 hour? He asked Peter, watch and pray so that you would not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. 42. He went away a second time and prayed, my Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done. When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more. Once more, take note of that, and pray the third time, saying the same thing. That is prayer of faith. Saying the same thing. That is prayer of faith. And then returned to the disciple and said to them, take your time to read. Faith about eternity. It is never prosper, like I have said, to base faith on our improvement. To base faith on our improvement after prayer. To base faith on our improvement after prayer oftentimes very, very disappointing. Oftentimes very what? Very disappointing. God, give me bread. And you base your faith on that, the outcome, bread. If the bread does not come, you'll be disappointed. We base our faith, it works with the will of God, the promise of God, altogether. What is His will? That is what faith works on. Is the will to give you bread or wait a while? To give you bread. According to his way, we pray. According to his promise, we pray. Jesus prayed that cup be taken away from him 3 times. Cup be taken away from him. Another time again. Cup be taken away from him. Another time again. Cup be taken away from me 3 times. The prayer of faith can be repeated 1,000 times. This is why the Bible encourages us in 1 Thessalonians 5:16, pray without ceasing. Prayer without what? Are you with me? They say prayer without what? Prayer without ceasing. Because our trouble, our challenges, our situation are instruments that maintain our union with God. Tell your neighbor, my challenges, my situation are instruments to maintain my union with God. What is it? Union. Look at this. My challenges, my trouble are instruments to maintain my oneness with God. To maintain my relationship with God. But today, opposite is the case to you. It is time you begin to see your challenge as a friend. Say to yourself, my challenges, my trouble are instruments to maintain my union, my oneness, my relationship. As Christians, when we pray to God to remove our troubles, when the trouble are not removed, an equivalent will be granted. Take note as a Christian. An equivalent will be granted, will be provided. That is why you are here. This is equivalent. That is where God guides you find yourself. Where His grace will be sufficient to protect you while you are going through the problem. Once again, as Christians, when we pray to God to remove our situation, to remove our infirmity, to remove our challenges, when the problems are not removed, an equivalent will be provided. That is why you are still pressing on. That is why your situation has not impaired you. That is why you are still there. Even though that situation is there, but you are strong in the Lord. That brought about our relationship. If not your situation, you will not know me. And if not your situation, I will not know you. Where will I know you? In the clubhouse? Where will I know you? In a party? Where will I know you? I will not know you. You are welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Can you say thank you, my situation?
Thank you, my situation.
You keep bullying yourself, keep dejected, worry, trouble because of your situation. When situation comes, it is time to grow stronger in the Lord. As Christian, we must know that our values must be tested. Against facts and experience, your value must be tested. You say, what is my value? How much do I worth? If you are no one, nobody will notice, nobody will bother you. Each time people talk about TBJ, I don't know. The name is disturbing them. That is value. If I'm no one, nobody will talk about me. Nobody will want to attack me. Nobody will want to challenge me. People believe challenging me is making name for themselves because of value. What I want. People want to write article on their newspaper. TV channel, just because they want it to sell. Look at this channel here today. It's the most watched Christian channel all over the world. That is the value. You must know that your value must be tested against facts and experience. Tell your neighbor, my value must be tested against fact and experience. Why you don't want to pay a price for your value? Which will ask you, if you truly believe in them, in your value. What people say about you, people do this, people hate you, people did that, attack, did that. Some of us here, you know, because they are looking for value. They want to create that value for themselves. You see them when the moment everywhere is quiet and the moment there is no movement. That is when you see them coming up. They want people to see them. That is how they create value for themselves. Huh? Of Peter serve as a good example of what we are talking about. Assumed Peter caught fish earlier. He would have missed the redemption. This show is failure to caught fish. His wasted hour on the sea kept him for a new level in life. Your sickness can keep you for a new level. Your disappointment can keep you for a new level. Failure can keep one for a new level. Hatred, persecution, temptation can do the same. Will keep you. And you keep saying, my colleagues are going. See my colleagues, they are there. They are making money. I don't have job. Joblessness. And you don't know that God is keeping you for a new level. What are the things you are praying for? Whose answer seems to delay? Maybe God wants to keep you for a new level. Maybe God keep you or preserve you to strengthen your desire and your determination for Him. Ask your neighbor, what are the things you are praying for? Whose answer seems to delay? Maybe God wants to preserve you. Maybe God wants to keep you for a new level. Maybe God wants to strengthen your desire and your determination for Him. You call your role model today, he will tell you what it takes to be your role model. as you count your blessing every day, take time to count also your failure. Because there are school for failure, school for blessing. What we are saying has nothing to do with age. Because you consider your age for everything you do. Has nothing to do with family. You consider your family everything you do. Has nothing to do with education, human natural gift. Because you consider all this, I'm a graduate, I'm a professor. I've been to this place, I've been to that place, I've traveled all over the world. See this man there, I am a professor, see him, he's an illiterate. It has nothing to do with him. By acting faith, you can only fetch in grace. Tell your neighbor, by acting faith, you can only fetch in grace that will enable you to do what is impossible. You know, I take my time to talk to you. No, I really want to talk to you. I really want to talk to you. That is why you are not saying, I'm expecting somebody to shout and say, Pastor, why are you quiet? I'm expecting to jump. Yes, yes, yes. Why can't you help me jump? I want to see. Mom. You don't need more for this. You just need the one God wants me to give you. You keep opening the door God has not opened. Tell your neighbor, you keep open the door God has not opened. So you see, this is why many of you are like this. You keep taking what God has not given you. What God has not given you. That is why it's difficult to live long with those things. At the time you need those things, they are not there for you because you take it when God has not given you. Many fame, popularity, wealth, achievement today. Fame, you know, popularity, wealth. If God has given you, He gave you for the children yet unborn to lead and see. This is why you see our life epileptic today. Epileptic. The time you are not strong, the thing is no longer there. Tell your neighbor, we keep taking what God has not given us. We keep opening the door God has not opened. That is the blessings of many and the wealth of many and the fame of many today. The joy of the blessing and the joy of the fame is to see it when you are no longer living. Die and leave it behind. Because you are not blessed only for this generation, but the generation yet unborn. If apostles have died with their achievement, people like me will not be here today. I'm an inheritor, a partaker of inheritance of saints. So you can still return what God has not given you and wait for what God is about to give you. It's not too late. Tell your neighbor, return what you have not given and wait for what God is about to give. This is a challenge all over the world. Not only you, the nation, the continent, the world. Every aspect of life, marriage, business, career, this, that. If God has not given you and you take it, not that you would not be able to take it, you can take it when God has, because the Bible said, the blessing I give, not as the world give them. You can take when God has not given you, you can take it, no problem. Time is the best. I want someone to smile with me. I want someone to smile here. You are too frank. Why are you too frank? Let me believe you. You are too frank. Smile. You have taken what God has not given you. Smile, 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 smile. Oh, no, this is not real. I want that kind of smile. Let me hear you. What are you saying there? You say you will return it. Thank you. Give thanks to him. Give thanks to him. Such a wonderful time having you around me. Do you know I love you? How do you know? How do you know that I love you? Because I have questions I want to ask you. How do you know I love you? Because, do you love me?
Yeah.
Because you come to the church, you love me. Yes. Yes. Don't worry. Time will tell. Tell your neighbor, time will tell. Do you know what I mean by time will tell? How can you be inside the church and say you hate me? you are inside the church and you are looking at me and you say, I hate you. It's very difficult. Time will tell when you're out there, we know. Time will tell. It's a matter of time. Even the question I'm asking is not even relevant. How can I be looking at you and you say, and I say, do you love me? What will I expect from you? Too much. You have not asked me whether I love you. No, ask me. I know you know I love you. Ask me a question. Okay. You say what? Okay, thank you for loving me. That is one side. Thank you for loving me. Because you say you love me, reciprocate. If you love me, I love you. That is it. That can work. Oh my God, thank you. Hallelujah. Yes. You join me pray for my country today. If you say you love me. But at this time, people are crying, pain. I cannot ask. I want everyone to be at their best. When you are at your best, you pray, it go. But right now, so we have some people carry placards. Okay, so thank you. Hallelujah. Yes. So don't forget our message today. Very important. The question asking you and the answer is an advice. It is never proper to base faith on how we are doing or our improvement after prayer. Give me biscuit. Lord Jesus, I want to win this contract. Lord Jesus, someone is waiting for me to give me $1 million. You fast, you pray, you're expecting that $1 million to be paid. If that $1 million is not paid, you will be very, very well, and that will affect your relationship. The prayer of faith can be repeated. We have read it in the book of Matthew. When Jesus prayed that cup be taken away from him, three times. Let this cup be taken away from me. Another day, let this cup be taken away from me. Another time, let this cup be taken away from me. Does it mean the first prayer were not prayer of faith? Does it mean the second one were not prayer of faith? Three times. So this is what the Bible means. In 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 16, it said, praying without ceasing. Without ceasing, without stop. Continue. The same, give me breath. If you are not given at that moment, maybe he wants to preserve you. He know if he give you that bread at that moment, it may be harmful to you. He will keep it and give you at the right time. And I give you a good message, example of Peter in Luke 5. It's started from verse 1 to 11. assume Peter caught fish earlier. He has been there very, very early. Assume Peter caught fish earlier, he would have missed this redemption. He would have met Jesus. He would have met Jesus. Jesus would have not found him there. It means his wasted hour there was a blessing. His wasted hour, his failure, kept him for a new level. Your situation, your temptation, maybe to keep you for what? To keep you for what? So therefore, why are we lamenting, murmuring, complaining? This is why I say, to learn how we receive answers to our prayer is much, much greater than what? The blessing you are seeking. So may God bless us well. So, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
My name is Cecilia Ba. I'm from Ghana.